Hi, this is Professor Kleitz. Continuing in section 8-6, I'm going to start with the gray code. This is another useful code used in digital systems. It's primarily used for indicating the angular position of a shaft on a rotating piece of machinery, such as automated lathes and drill presses. This code is like binary in that we have as many bits as necessary, and the more bits, the more possible combinations of output codes. The number of combinations, therefore, would be 2 to the n. If you have a 4-bit gray code, for example, 2 to the 4th is 16 different representations, giving us a resolution of 1 of 16 possible angular positions at 22 degrees each. And you get that just by taking 360 divided by 16. So the resolution is not great, but in some cases that'll be enough. Otherwise, you could do 2 to the 5th or 2 to the 6th or whatever it is for how detailed you want your resolution. So in table 8-4, I'm comparing the two code systems. The binary code just goes 0, 1, 2, 2 to 1 is a 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all the way up to 15, whereas the gray code is slightly different. Starts with 0 and then goes to 1, but then instead of going to 2, what it does is it changes the next bit, the 2 to the first bit, to a 1, and then after that it changes the 2 to the 1 bit to a 0, and then after that it keeps these two bits the same but adds a third bit, and so on. And as you go down through this code sequence, you'll notice that every one of these is different in some way. And so there's 16 completely different 4-bit codes listed. The order is not a straight counter like it is in binary. And the reason they do this in gray code is that when you move from one position to the next, only one bit changed. From here to here, one bit change. From here to here, one bit change would be this one. From here to here, one bit change. Here to here, only one bit change. Whereas when you look in binary, here to here, one bit changed. Here to here, two bits changed. This one changed and this one's changed. And what happens if you use this as a code on a piece of rotating machinery, depending on if you're right next to the edge, you could have two bits changing at the same time, introducing a possible error. And even worse than that is when you get down to, let's say, the number 7. When you go from this position, if this is the code on a rotating shaft, to this position, all 4 bits are changing. So the chance of error is greatly increased. Whereas in the gray code, when you go from here to here, only one bit changed. That would be the most significant bit. So again, the gray code is only one bit for each position, giving us a much more accurate measurement technique for rotating machinery. So let's see how we build these gray codes. And before we do that, we can look at a gray code wheel. So here's the codes. It's going to be on a piece of rotating machinery, 0000, and then notice just one bit changed. And then the next position, only one bit changed. Next position, only one bit changed, and so on all the way around this wheel. So to convert from binary to gray code, a series of exclusive OR gates. You put the binary code on here and you'll automatically get the gray code out for the corresponding binary that we saw in that table. And going the other way, you put the gray code in on this side, you'll automatically get the binary out. Now notice the circuit connections are slightly different from figure 40 to figure 41. So if we put ones and zeros on the first circuit, this is going to be a binary to gray code converter. If you start with the binary 0110 and try to determine what the gray code for that would be, you would put the 0110 on here. Remember, the way exclusive gates work, exclusive ORs, is if one or the other but not both. So here we have one or the other, yeah, so we'll get a one out. And then here, this one and a one is a 0 out, and then this 1 with a 0 is a 1 out, and then that 0 is connected right to the output. Look this up in the gray code chart that we saw back in table 8-4, and you'll see that this worked out for the conversion. And of course we want to be able to go the other way, where you have a gray code and convert it back into binary. So let's just pick this gray code 0011, And this one goes into an exclusive. Actually, we have to start on the left side in order to solve this. So you got a 0 that comes straight through. 0, 0 would give you a 0 out of an exclusive OR. Then this 0 with a 1 gives you a 1. And then this 1 with a 1 gives you a 0. Look this up and make sure that this is the correct binary code for the inputted gray code. Okay, so that completes my discussion of gray code. Make sure you do the problems at the end of the chapter related to this. And next, I'm going to talk about multiplexers in section 8-7.